È già collegata con noi una delle pers un personaggio centrale nella discussione sull'innovazione nella robotica, ma ne avrà da raccontarci, ci racconterà le prospettive anche dell'agenda globale, proprio di come questa pandemia abbia influito proprio sul cambiamento di cui parlavamo prima e di cui ci accennava anche la ministra. Stiamo parlando dello scienziato Hiroaki Kitano, presidente e CEO di Sony Computer Science Laboratories, che è collegato con noi. Welcome.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi. Well, thank you very much for
Thank
inviting me
you.
for the opening speech for the Maker Faire 2021 Rome. I think that we are in a transitional, transformative change period. I think this is in a very important time in our life. We know because of the COVID-19 pandemic, otherwise I would prefer to be there, but at the same time, we are getting more flexibility in the way that how we work and how, in our lifestyle. Now, at the same time, one of the shocking thing I find out in the, COVID-19 is although we did a global economic shutdown, early last year, we found out the carbon dioxide emission decrease only about like a 10-year time span. Like we only able to go back to the level of the emissions 2010. And that's now, almost back to the, pre-corona stage. And of course, all the global climate issues, and we have to find a new way. Simply shutting, slowing down the economy is not a solution. That was a very clear indication of the, economic lockdown. And we found out that is not the solutions. That means we have to make the very transformative change in the lifestyle, the industry, and the energy system. The theme of this Maker Faire is the future in the making. So the question is, what is the kind of future we would like to make? So it's very interesting to find out that COVID actually is a catalyst for the change. We suffered a lot. I'm very sorry for who passed away from the COVID, and then very sorry about someone who lost the loved ones. But at the same time, we learned a lot of major lessons that lifestyle can be changed. And I think, even after the, this corona, we probably got vaccinated, they got the efficient drugs, and then maybe the virus evolution make it more easier for us to deal with in the coming years. But we're not going to simply go back to the pre-COVID days. I think this has been the catalyst. We're going to a transformative change right now. Now, at the same time, we recognize this corona is not the last pandemic we're going to face. Historically, there have been a pandemic for potential for the pandemic every 4 or 5 years. We just be preventing it. And the pandemic for corona every 20, 30 years, for example, 120 years ago, there's a Russian flu, which has actually it another corona, which is OC43, which is common corona, just to get the common cold right now. But at that time, it was very lethal. And then we got the Hong Kong flu, Asian flu, and the Russian flu, the Soviet flu, all kind of pandemic, in average every 20 years. So we have to be prepared for that, even that happened again in the future. And then one of the reasons that pandemic frequency might actually increase is the loss of the biodiversity. So I think we need to be able to, accommodate our civilizations, how we protect the biodiversity, how we're going to prevent climate changes. And otherwise, the future we're going to make is not going to be the good things. So I think we need to be able to accommodate our civilizations and restore the global ecosystem. And I think that is a very important challenge. At the Sony Computer Science Lab, which I am the CEO, we are running several interesting programs, which I would like to mention briefly. It's one of the projects is silviculture, that is a new way of agriculture. Now, agriculture is extremely stressful for the environment in a way that you plant the industrial agriculture, you put the one kind of crops or the agriculture products, that means the biodiversity goes down to the one. And then that actually gives quite substantial stress to the global ecosystem. At the same time, like what we are doing at Single Culture is we implant 150 or different crops and try to design the micro ecosystem. So therefore, we can enhance the biodiversity, and we want to expand that more. Stable agriculture yield, increase biodiversity, and I think that would be the one of the solutions. We also have like a microgrid system and a space telecommunication system or other thing we might actually help us to solve the global agenda issues. I think it's a great time for us to embark on the grand challenge to have cybernetic earth that is, we're gonna be managing our ecosystem, transform the lifestyle, and then we also want to have a digitized city as well, so that we can have more convenience at the same time inclusions of the diverse people with a diverse background, the diverse conditions. So I think this is a really interesting agenda for in terms of the Makersphere, a future in the making. This theme actually reminds me my 21 years ago. I was invited to be invited artist to the Biennale di Venezia, and the theme was the cities. And what we are presented is the city going to be virtual, or digitized the physical integrations. Actually, very early I did digital twins. Now, what I would say is not only the physical and the digital integration, but that have to be embedded in the context of global ecosystems, enhance biodiversity and transformative change in lifestyle. Therefore, our activity will actually enhance biodiversity and be able to manage the global ecosystem. So I think we'll transform into the era that will design complex emerging ecosystem globally, and our lifestyle will be much better. And one of the interesting study in a Cambridge University professor says the quality of life in a specific city depends on how many bird species you can observe in the city. That is the single most significant correlator of the quality of life, much more than economic indicator. So that, I think, is a very interesting study that we should enjoy in the future. So future in the making, I would say, is the world which we're going to actively transform with the lessons of the climate change and the pandemic, and have a much flexible lifestyle, harnessing biodiversity, and then able to, properly design and control the global ecosystem. Well, thank you very much, and I hope you enjoy the Maker Faire. I'm sorry that I won't be able to get there, but next time I hope to be in Rome physically, not virtually. Thank you very much.